I've been coding for about 5 years now. I started learning when I was 10, and I've been coding ever since. I used to see my dad doing whatever this was on his computer. I didn't really understand it. And I was like, what is this? What is this crazy, cool-looking stuff that my dad is doing?
Trying to configure a SSL certificate.
She's a really, like, super curious kid. I started teaching her really raw coding concepts, and she was able to comprehend it like a little sponge.
Once I really got into it, I learned, okay, I actually like this stuff. Every once in a while, I kind of realized, like, well, I'm making a difference, or I'm making an impact, and I want other girls like me to feel like they can do that too. My dad actually first learned to code while he was in prison.
At that time, I was doing what I feel like I had to do to help my family. I just remember saying, I'm going to figure out how to get out of this neighborhood. And I made some bad choices. I ended up in prison when JJ was only 3 years old.
Visits and phone calls took a lot of money. So talking to him wasn't, you know, so easy to do. We didn't always have envelopes and stamps because we didn't really have it in our budget.
This is one from you, Jayana. How old were you? So you were
like seven.
Seven.
I love you, Daddy. You're the best. Love. Can't stop saying loving you, Dad.
Being in there, he knew that he had to find something so that he can come home with a new skill under his belt, something that was promising for him. So while he was in prison, he took the initiative to learn how to code.
I created the first prototype of PhotoPatch, a simple website. I wanted it to be something that was just as easy as posting to social media. That way it feels natural, it feels like something that they do regularly, and it's not a pain to actually communicate with the person you love.
As soon as he came home, he got right into it.
I started to flesh PhotoPatch out more and was like, you know what, this can change a lot of lives. JJ one day was like, you know what, Dad? The website looks good, but we can really use a mobile app. And I'm like, you're right.
So I just took the initiative to build it out. Most people pay developers thousands of dollars. Me just was kind of like trying it out on my own, trying to see what I can do. And I did hit like moments where I was like, okay, I don't really know what I'm doing, but I wanted to try to figure it out. I can be like a perfectionist sometimes, so I really want things to look a certain way and be a certain way. So whenever it looked like it was done, I was like, no, I still want to do this. I still want to try this.
3-4 months later, she came back with her version of the mobile app. Completed, beautiful, functional. It was surreal. I was like, what is happening here? What is really happening here? A 13-year-old built this mobile app.
After the app was released, it really kind of took off because people really needed it. It's not a privilege for kids to be able to talk to their parents. It's a right. Children should have the right to talk to their parents no matter where they are. We're really excited because we're about to launch PhotoPatch app 2.0.
Now we have real-time updates. You send out your letter, you'll get a message when the post office delivered it.
On three, we're gonna go live. You ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, send. Boom.
13 years old, she was the junior director of PhotoPatch, at meetings with us, helping us put on events, debugging the app. One day, we went around a circle and said, what do we want in the next 10 years for PhotoPatch? And JJ literally looked at me and said, I want your position. She said she wanted to run PhotoPatch one day. And she will. I know she will.
Now, young lady, I heard that you're currently enrolled in a new coding class.
Oh, I'm actually giving a coding class, so I'm teaching kids online how to do coding. Not only are there not a lot of people of color in tech, but there also aren't a lot of women. I mean, if you're ready and willing to do it, just get into it. Stay dedicated, stay focused.
It's really contagious to see this young spirit just getting started.
I want other girls like me to feel like they can be bosses too and they can make a difference. I want to try to get 10,000 women of color into the tech world myself.
This is just the beginning. This is just the beginning of a new day.
Just